Excel now has an AI function called labs.generative.AI that allows you to write your prompt in a formula. It can also reference cells in the worksheet. It runs on OpenAI, so essentially it's just like having ChatGPT in a formula. It's available in Excel 2021 or later, or with a Microsoft 365 license, and I'll show you how to install it. But first, let's take a look at some of the cool things you can do with it. Here, I'm going to use it to return the airport codes for this list of cities. So simply type in equals labs.generative.AI and then enter the prompt in double quotes. I want it to return only the three-letter airport code 4, and then with an ampersand, reference the airport name in column J. And just like that, we have a list of airport codes. And because it's a formula, I can edit the values being referenced and it will fetch new data. For example, I'll change Toronto to Sydney and Kingsford Smith. And there we go. The key is in how specific you are with the prompt. If I simply ask for the airport code, it would most likely return a whole sentence preceding the code, which is not what I want. Alternatively, I can limit the number of characters returned using the max token argument. Roughly speaking, one token equals 4 characters in English. So if I edit the prompt and remove the specification to return only a 3-letter airport code, and then add a max token of 1, I should get the 3-letter codes. But as you can see, the max token isn't being respected. We can also use labs.generative.AI to return tables and lists of results. For example, let's say you need a list of all the states in the USA, along with their abbreviations. Instead of copying them from the web, you can simply use the labs.generative.AI function. So starting with the labs function, I want to return a comma-separated list of the 50 states in the United States of America with no leading text. Now I need to wrap it in the text split function to separate each state name into its own cell. My delimiter is a comma followed by a space. And then I need to use transpose to spill the results down a column. Now keep in mind, the more data you request, the longer it takes. And there we go. All right, next I'll write another formula to return the state abbreviation. And again, I need to be clear that it doesn't include any leading text. And then concatenate the state name. Now you might be tempted to use the spilled array operator here to reference the state names, but the generative AI function can't reference spilled arrays. So instead, I'm going to reference one cell at a time and copy it down. And there I have a list of the states and their abbreviation. Of course, ideally I'd ask it to return a 2-column table containing the state name and abbreviation, but I found that it wouldn't separate the states and the abbreviation with a comma delimiter, despite me asking. So 2 separate formulas was the next best thing. While extracting lists of data from the web is one application, labs.generative.AI can also create new content for you. Let's say you're starting an online gadget store. You want to list 100 products in the store and you need a short description for each of them. You can go ahead and write them yourself or use labs.generative.AI to do it for you. We can also get the product specifications from the web using this function. Let's take a look. Here I have a list of Samsung phones. I'm going to use the labs function to return a short description for this product and concatenate the product name. Notice here I can also use table structured references. And then next, I'll use the temperature argument to reduce the amount of randomness of the results. Now at 0, the model should almost always return the same results. However, there is no guarantee. And now I have a list of products and their descriptions. Let's get the specs. Again, equals labs.generative.AI. Get the specs 4 and concatenate the product name. I'll use a temperature argument to reduce the randomness with 0. Now it can take a little while to return text-heavy responses, so you have to be patient. And now you can see it's done a pretty good job, except there are a couple of phones it doesn't think are released yet, even though they are. And here's the first problem. The AI models are only updated periodically, so the output can lag real-time information, which might not be an issue for you, but something to be mindful of. Another use for the function is conducting sentiment analysis of your text. For example, here I have some comments from one of my videos on buy coal and buy row, and I'm going to ask it to analyze and classify them into positive, negative, and neutral. Equals labs.generative.AI, use one word to summarize this text into positive, negative, or neutral, and concatenate the comment column. Now, there's a lot of text for it to sift through, so this can take a little while. And there we go. It does a pretty good job, but it struggles to know what to do when there's both positive and negative comments, as in the case of row 9. I probably classify this as neutral because ultimately they're complaining about Excel as opposed to my video. Because the function can reference a cell, we can ask it to explain formulas that are in files we might have inherited or simply can't remember writing. Here I have a SUMIFS formula that's referencing an Excel table using structured references, which makes it pretty easy to follow. But if you're not familiar with SUMIFS, then labs.generative AI can certainly help. I'm going to ask it to explain this formula step by step. Now, if I just reference the cell, it's going to see the result, which is 209,400. So I need to use the formula text function to expose the formula that's in the cell. And I'll use the model argument to specify using GPT-4, which will hopefully be better at understanding and explaining formulas than the default model. Okay, this formula is used in Excel for specific conditional summing. It explains this is an Excel function that sums cells that meet multiple criteria. And it talks about the different ranges being referenced. And then the last sentence. So the formula sums the values in the sales column of the sales data table where the corresponding value in the category column matches the value in cell C6. So you can see it did a pretty good job. I also used it to explain a more complex lambda formula that calculates income tax based on a progressive tax system. And sometimes it did a great job, and other times it seemed a bit lazy and just stopped partway through, which may be due to my settings, which I'll explain a bit more on in a moment. The function is available to Excel 2021 and Microsoft 365 users in the Excel Labs add-in. Now, if you haven't already got the add-in, go to the Home tab, Add-ins, More Add-ins, and search for Excel Labs, and then click Add. It'll then be available on the far right of the Home tab of the ribbon. So click open, and under configure API key, it explains that you have to register an OpenAI account and enter your API key. And there's a link that will take you to get your API key if you don't already have one. And then in the settings, you can specify the default model, temperature, maximum output length, which is measured in tokens. And if you hover over the slider, an explanation of each setting pops up. So I'll leave you to read through them. Of course, you can override these settings using the optional arguments in the formula. If you get the hash busy error that eventually resolves to a hash NA error, it can mean one of two things. You've either exceeded your daily token limits or you need to add funds to your OpenAI account. When you set up your OpenAI account, you get some credit that lasts for 30 days, but once you use it all or it expires, you need to then add funds to your account. You'll find this information under the Usage tab when you're logged into OpenAI. Now, if your account is funded and you're still getting the errors, then it will be a token limit, in which case you can try changing the AI model in the settings. The labs.generative AI formulas appear, for the most part, to be volatile, recalculating every time any other formulas on the sheet are edited or structural changes like inserting or deleting rows and columns are made. To avoid this, paste the output as values, or while writing the formulas, put the workbook into manual calculation mode via the Formulas tab. Just don't forget to recalculate using the F9 key or Shift F9 to only recalculate the active worksheet, or by putting the workbook back into automatic calculation mode. The labs.generative AI function is just one way you can leverage AI inside Excel, but there are actually loads of AI features available, which I've covered here and here. So check out those videos next. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe for more, and I'll see you in the next video.